Okay, guys, so we're going to play around with preliminary defense for the rear anchor choke. So you can jump on my back, man. So a lot of times what happens is from the back, our hands are kind of our first line of defense, right? I want to use my hands to prevent him from getting his arm around my neck. But once he starts to get his arm around my neck, now, usually once the arm wraps around my neck, it's pretty easy for him to be able to choke me. So can you feel, like, even just with one arm, can you put some pressure on my neck and mm-hmm. start to... So even from there, he can start to choke me, okay? So the idea is, once his arm has started to come around my neck, so once I've kind of lost the battle of the hands being able to grab his arms and protect, there's a very simple adjustment that I can make which will prevent him from being able to squeeze and put pressure on my neck. So I'm gonna change the angle to basically create a disconnection for his arm against my neck. And how I do that is I'm gonna turn my head and I actually look at him. So if you go to squeeze my neck right now, squeeze my neck.
No chance.
Right. And so one of the important things is from here, even if he's using his head against me, okay, and right now I'm gonna actually, the goal for me is to actually lean my head and use my head and push the back of my head and my ear into his chest. So it's almost like I'm trying to listen to his heart. Can you squeeze me right there?
No.
Right? And so this is extremely helpful in immediately trying to relieve pressure and connection of the neck, because once he gets his arm around my neck, things will start to get tight. And so I will always turn my head towards the elbow of the arm he's trying to choke me with. The other thing that we want to do, which is not very common, is I'm actually gonna look up and give him my neck. So most of the time what happens is people want to tuck their head and tuck their chin. The problem with that is if I tuck my chin, if he goes over my chin, and we've seen this many times, what happens is if he starts to squeeze and he has a good squeeze on his choke, he can either break my jaw or I will still choke through the chin, right? He can still choke me. And so I never wanna put my chin or my face in harm's way. And so the idea is, as he starts to wrap around my neck, I'm actually going to turn my face and I look my head up. My head goes up. And right now, even if he squeezes, there's some pressure on the side of my head, but he doesn't have the side of my neck here, which is close to his armpit. There's a ton of space there. So do you feel you can choke me anymore from that angle?
No way.
Right? And so this is a really, really important drill, and it's a very subtle movement that I'm doing. I'm just basically turning my head. And so you can even do this drill with your eyes closed, where I'm sitting, I've given my opponent my back, and I'm sitting a little bit lower than his shoulder line. The reason I sit myself a little bit lower than his shoulder line is because it's a lot easier for him to actually get around my neck with my shoulder just below his shoulder line. If I'm sitting too high up, he almost has to reach too far over. Even if I'm here, that feels a little bit better, but just me being able to turn my head and change the angle, does that feel better for you anymore?
Whoa.
So I just lean back and rest my ear against his chest, and now he's kind of lost the angle to be able to squeeze that choke. Okay, so all I did was basically lean back and I'm driving my ear into his chest. Squeeze. This whole side is completely open for me. And so this is a preliminary defense, and all it requires us to do, so if he comes in with the other hand to choke me, I'm turning my head, ear goes against his chest, and I want to look up at him. And it completely frees up my neck over here, even if he reaches all the way around, right? And the other thing that this does is it teaches me how to start moving to the right side. So obviously with the rear naked choke, the goal for us is to move away from the choking arm, okay? And so as my head goes up and as my head goes back, I'm already starting to fall energy towards my head, towards the correct side. So now I'm out of the choke, okay? So this is a really, really important for the rear naked choke, is understanding this action with the head to be able to basically defend the choke.